Hi guys, today we are having a seminar with Fountainhead School based in Surat, Gujarat, and we are covering the topic for almost 100 plus students about how to master design thinking. This school is affiliated with IB board, and they have a process of very conceptual learning for their students, which is very much inclined towards practical understanding of the kids and how in day-to-day basis they can use those practical knowledge for their well-being. So we are going to start the session from 2:45 to 3:30 with the students online, and this is it. So keep watching.
Good afternoon, everyone. To all present here, students, teachers, and our special guest today. So today with us, we have Disha and Ankit, Disha Sangal and Ankit Sangal. They are a couple and they are running graphic designing studio in Delhi. And they have taken the precious time out to take this guest session for us. Today they will be talking about the design thinking, how design process actually works in the real world, what all issues they face when dealing with clients. And as we have talked earlier, that our students are working on the same lines on e-portfolio. They also have a client. So yes, students, you will get a lot of insight. So please be attentive in this session. Over to you, Disha and Ankit.
Thank you so much, Tulsa. And thank you, Fountainhead School, for inviting us for this session. And like Tulsa suggested, we are husband wife. We are running an agency based in Delhi. And it's been 5 years since we've started this. Basically, we provide solutions like branding and packaging design. Ankit, please introduce
yourself. So these solutions are, integrated with well thought process of how aesthetically we can use designs for anybody who is coming to us for any requirement. So bahut aam bhasha mein, for in a very general way, I would say a design begins when you hand over your business card. That business card carries some design etiquette, and from there people judges you. So this is where we come in the place, and we plan everything. And now I'm sharing the screen, and we'll take you through a couple of case studies.
Yeah. So till then, let me just give you some idea about this whole presentation that we are sharing with you. So basically, when we're talking about mastering design thinking, the whole idea is coming up with right solution for the problem that is faced by the user, the end user. And the whole process, the 6 steps process that we take, or any other design studio or an agency or a creative person, that they are supposed to take those process, the steps, and which helps you to come up with ideas.
Sure.
Is it clear? The screen?
Yes.
Great. So like we've already introduced ourselves, our little studio, a graphic design studio based in Delhi, husband wife. Then I'll move forward. So design thinking and its purpose. So in a very simple definition, for design thinking is a creative process to find solutions for a product or service that could communicate and be identified by the user with ease in the market. In simple language, coming up with proper solution that could be in form of a logo, branding, packaging design, could be anything. And then a solution that helps the user to communicate with their target audience in the market. Design thinking process. So this is the process that we take. There's a brief that's been given from the client. So the brief is that it's a brief coming from the client. They come up with their own requirements and the challenges that they're facing. Post that, we start doing the research. We study about the competition there in the market. We try to understand the target audience and what all problems the current, the brand or company is facing. Post that, we start working on the whole idea generation. So there are a lot of exercises, mind mapping, brainstorming, preparing mood boards. On basis of those exercises, we come up with different ideas. Then we present these ideas to the client. Once the client, like we present 3 to 4 options to the client. Once they go through it, they come up with their own feedback. That is the review and revisions. Post that, when we are able to, there's a mutual discussion. Post that, we come up with the final designs. And these final designs are further developed into the different collaterals and then launched in the market. So this is the 6-step process that we follow or any creative person should follow.
So all of these steps have their own importance, and these importance will be correlated further once we get along with all the case studies here we are about to show you.
Yeah. So basically, we would be covering 4 different case studies. Case study 1 is logo or a branding. Then 2nd is print materials, digital materials. That could be a poster, flyers, brochure. Case study 3 represents packaging design. And case study 4 is stationery and merchandise. So case study 1, that is logo and branding.
What happens is when, to explain better to kids, when you see any logo for any of the brands, there's a well thought. If there is a logo for school fountain head, so that logo must be, well planned, and how their complete branding of the school has come up. So it is very important for any organization or any company to come up with particularly well thought process for that complete branding to come up. So this is how some of the client came to us, and they wanted to have an institution which is all about nutritions, and it is all virtual institution. And the brief was that we want a logo which should be very progressive in a way. कि अगले 10 साल तक हमको कुछ और अपनी आइडेंटिटी में चेंजेस करने की जरूरत ना पड़े, बिकॉज वर्ल्ड इज इवॉल्विंग सो फास्ट. तो एज अ डिजाइनर हमारा ड्यूटी है, हाउ डू वी फॉलो दैट, दिस इज अ वेरी क्लियर ब्रीफ. सो नाउ द एग्जीक्यूशन वी आर शोइंग हियर इज दैट पर्टिकुलर लोगो इज इज बीन शोड इन 3 काइंड ऑफ ऑप्शंस. एंड देन वी विल शो यू व्हाट गॉट फाइनलाइज्ड, हाउ डिड वी केम अप विद दीस 3 ऑप्शंस. And everything, Disha.
So basically, we came up with 3 different options. The first option, I would say, is very progressive. Second option is a very contemporary design. And third is a traditional. That is the approach we take. We try to give different options to the client. So when we talk about nutrition, we thought of greenery, leaf, and salads. So we took a shape of a leaf, an abstract shape, and we created a customized font for this client, and we design Institute Nutrition for them. And so IT, all the letters, they have a feeler of a leaf in it. In option 2, which is very contemporary, we wanted to show that the health is a continuous process. So we decided to take letter I and N, and we showed the pyramid also, the triangles, the negative spaces are basically a food pyramid. And we just wanted to show that it is a continuous thing, it keeps on moving on. Option 3, like we suggested, it's a very traditional university kind of logo. We took book and a leaf, and we created this shape out of it. To come to this,
So what happens is cutting the tea from here. If you see the cutting the tea from here, or carving it from here, or reducing the spaces between the letters. These are the ways where you can customize the font in your own way, and you can explain it to your client. And now the next step is, after this logo gets finalized, how do you use it further for the client? So now we are representing the client after the logo gets freeze, that incomplete branding, that how he can use this logo on the homepage of his website. That representation, how they can use it on mobile application, and how they can share the message, represent the images, create a pan where
the images, you know, resonates to nutritional aspects, content, connection to the food basket, and then human connection. Disha, you want to add into it?
So basically, the whole init concept, we've taken it, we've basically carried forward in the entire collaterals, if you see. Now, in the social media creators also, we took this init concept, in sickness, eat it. So it was very important that people should be able to recall this again and again. It becomes a part in your brain. Okay, it Institute of Nutrition. So this was some other posters that we designed for him. Then comes the merchandise part. Ankit, please explain.
Yeah. So once the logo has been done, the complete presentation has been done, how do you further use the logo? Then you create a kit for your client. And that kit, you know, can be, carved into a sticker for a laptop or a personalized notebook or a zipper or a t-shirt or a pen drive. And this is how you give a visual aspiration to your client, basically to, you know, make him think that how good his brand is looking and how he can, you know, foresee that, okay, this will be the impact of my brand. And this will be the impact of my logo. And this is really important for anybody who is into design industry to make their clients understand that what is the implications of what we are designing. If you can see that these are the accessories, that pen or a sticker on a car or a cutlery or a cap, a tote bag, like a slogan where I am in it, or a lanyard, which we use in educational institute. So this all ideation process, a designer is responsible to, you know, ideate all of the content, all of the design aspect, how the collaterals will get developed, like this simple line, I am in it, which gives a clear indication to anybody who's interacting with this brand that, okay, I am in it. So that ways. Now,
talk about the logo and also the color scheme that you have chosen over here is orange.
So again, now the process, getting on to the steps, if you remember when we were talking about these steps here, that once the concept and idea generation is there, so once we have created a concept of init, an idea was generated, then we have designed and developed the solution. Then we have shared the review and revision. So, kya kiya? Jab client ko ek idea or concept humne dikha diya yahan pe ki ye ideas hain, ye pure concepts hain. To fir client ka yahan pe preference ye hota hai ki, okay, my preference is that I'm very fond of an orange color, right? So then we have to hear to client and understand why orange only, why not blue, which we are suggesting. Then he will come with the reasonings that this is my brand color. I have two other brands who also have a orange color, and I want to keep all my brands in the same umbrella. Then
your mic is muted. Disha, your mic is muted.
Okay, am I audible? Okay, so then it is up to client what exactly client want. He understood the concept, he understood the design. Now the color, the placements and everything, aesthetics wise, we have to take the feedback of the client. And from there, we go to it and we create this. And once we create this, we infuse some design elements, some color combinations, and create a color shade which we present to the client. And this is how brandings get done.
So I would like to further add on this. When, say, suppose a designer is working on the concept, and can we go back to the color palette, please? So if you're working on a design concept and we come up with different color ideas, so I'll just give you a theory how to come up with different ideas. So if you see the logo, one option, we thought of taking blue. So when it's about nutrition, everybody would play with green color. Then we have to be a little smart over here, what all colors we can try. Why we have taken orange? Because orange is all about health, friendliness, warmth. Same as with blue. Blue brings a sense of freshness. And in order to show something like university or an education center, we can play with navy colors and indigo shades. So this is how you think of different concept and we come up with different
ideas.
You
have to research. Again, this comes out with the research once you do Google out and see what universities are using colors on their logo. And you do 10, 15 universities, you find out their website, you find out what colors they are using on their website, what is the logo. So we found out that navy blue, red, and blue are some common colors out of 5-7 colors. And these are the basic study colors for every organization who's into teaching and institute development. So that's how we decide on it. So this is case study one, and case study one will help you understand that personal branding kaise banti hai, right? Now the case study moving ahead with case study two, we all have newspapers and lot of magazines in our houses, and once we open the newspapers, we see a lot of flyers and collaterals coming out of newspaper, and we interact with those things. So the idea behind those flyers, how do we, being a designer, how do we, ideate it? हम कैसे सोचते हैं उस flyer के बारे में, किस तरह से हम उसको plan करते हैं, उस जो आप सिर्फ एक 10 सेकेंड या 15 सेकेंड के लिए एक flyer देखते हो या एक advertisement देखते हो आप magazine में या social media पे, उसको हम कैसे plan करते हैं? This is what we want to show in this case study. Okay, since Gujarat is a state where a lot of pharmaceutical companies based out, and so we thought of taking a pharmaceutical background. We have a client who came to us that I need a catalog for a company where we want to highlight all our product offerings, and that catalog should be such that if we want, we can use it in a small brochure also. If we want, we can use certain elements in a flyer also. And if we want, we can use any image out of it as a paper ad also. And for your information, this company belongs to Nepal. Okay. So now we have created a catalog for them, and you are seeing same content, same company, but three different options. How did we came up with three different options? In option one, we are using an emotional connect with the picture of a family. That healthcare company providing medicines for a family. In option two, we are only focusing on the company and its logo. Option three, we are very clear in the communication. Okay, this catalog is about a company which is into medicines directly. So emotional, which is progressive, direct, which is traditional, and using medicines, which is contemporary. Again, the approach is same as we have used in the case study one. Next page. Now, these are the inner pages. When we are talking about the company, what are the offerings? What are the mission? What is the vision of the company? The content in all of the creatives are same, but representation of the content is different. And how do we ideate it? That's the task, because we have to give the option to the client. So we can't do it ki theek hai ye yahan pe font change kar diya aur yahan pe niche likh diya ya ye cheeze yahan likhi hain dusre option mein yahan likh di, aise nahi chalega. Hum kahin pe agar humne logo hai company ka to us logo ko ek continuity dekhe humne use kiya hai with an image. We have used icons here, we have used again a lateral way of presenting things. Disha.
So basically, I'll explain in option one, what we have done is, like Ankit suggested, it has a very emotional expression to this brochure. So we have taken the symbol M because it has a nice wave to it. And we thought, let's play with this wave.
This is a logo, not symbol M actually.
This
is the part of the logo.
Yeah, so basically the M that you see behind it, it's a part of the logo. It's a symbol of M. So what we have done is we have played around with that symbol, and we have taken very abstract pictures that generate emotional touch to it. We have played with a very handwritten style of font also. In every option, the fonts are very different. So if you see in first option, just to have that emotional connection, we have taken a handwritten font. in option two, we wanted to keep it very contemporary. So we've just played with different visuals, and the font is a very stencil style because we just wanted to show that how important this pharma company is there, and how much strong mission they have. In option three, if you see, we've played with different icons. So commitment has a different icon, mission has different icon, and then we've stick to a very traditional, simple corporate font. Similarly, I'll show you other pages. We talk about milestone. They wanted to show the milestone. Now, milestone is a very aspirational page. We wanted to have a very strong impact. Again, we have taken the same logo, M, and we have shown this different milestone. In option two, we have played with the pattern. And again, all the fonts are very contemporary. And in option three, we have shown growth. Same content, everything is same. Even the color palette is same because they have the logo colors. But the whole approach is different in all the three options.
Elements are different.
Yes, the elements are totally different.
And by the way, every company has a milestone, very important for them. How did they start it? What all achievements were there in the midway when they are progressing? So this was really an important page. So that's how it is really important how to take it up. And then showcasing the team. Here we are taking an approach of M again and putting team together. Here using the logo of the company to create a brand recall with the message and the team. Here different way of process of the company and team. So same thing, designs are very subjective again. Same thing can be done in different ways with different set of minds. You have to understand that. Because there is nothing right and nothing wrong here.
So just to add to this, in case if they asked for a pop-up brochure, for example. So nowadays it's quite intense. So if you were to add that element to it, how would it look like?
So let's say if they are asking for a flyer or a pop-up brochure. Right. And this is the inner page where they're talking about company. Okay. So if we have designed it, so what will happen is we'll slightly tweak it. We'll cut short with the content. Come up with some product section here. We'll use the same image and we'll create it and create an A4 or A5 size, a flyer or a pop-up thing. And that same creative can be, used on the social media handles as well as on the print way where it can be circulated via a newspaper or a magazine. So this is how, that tweaking you have to do it. But again, it is our job to plan it in such a way that client comes to us and say, "Yaar, aisa chahiye, toh hum karke de sake usko." Because we have to also think about, we have to not waste money of our client, right?
And in pop-up brochure, it's also important that what kind of product you're handling. Say, suppose a brochure is a very detailed, this one's a very detailed. A pop-up brochure will have a very limited content. So when you know that the content is very limited and it is very specific, design elements are less and the focus is on the communication, the message. So that time you just play with one picture and some elements and content, that's it.
We also have to understand, what is the audience which is going to interact with that brochure? What is the age group? Let's say this brochure was made because of the for Thailand audience, right? So they wanted to have a company based out of Nepal, and selling their products in Thailand. So they wanted to have something which is clear, very polished, very sophisticated, high-ranking medicines in that. So you have to plan that way. If it would have been, let's say, audience for Bihar, so they would have worked slightly on the content-wise, make it much easier, and focus on the medicines which are working in Bihar, area-specific, region-specific, country-specific. You have to work around that. So this was case study two. Now we are taking you towards the product design or product packaging design, I would say. This is case study three. And being a designer and the company who's working for them, is like FMCG is the sector, fast-moving consumer goods, and snack industry. We all have interacted with products like chips, nachos, snacks, and we all feel that we just go buy the product and move ahead, right? But we want to explain to you that what is the effort being a designer we take? What is the thought process? we put in and how do we think that a particular consumer who is going to have this snack will interact and why they will buy this product, right? So this is a brand in Agra, Panchi Peta. It's a world famous product. Everybody who goes to Agra to see Taj Mahal and visit it, they buy Panchi ke products and Panchi Peta and namkeens and everything. So we last year we planned their repackaging for all the snacks which they are providing. Now, from where, what was the current business model? The current business model, they were having 15-20 outlets in the city of Agra. Anybody going to their store, buying the snacks, buying the namkeens from the outlet, half kg to 50 grams, 1 kg, same time, you know, pack with a label and move on. Yeah. Now, from there, we want to get it in a commercialized way, what Haldiram or Bikano or Bikaji is doing. So we designed three options again here. This was the option one, that this is option two, and this is option three. Again, the approach was something contemporary, something progressive, and something what is already there in the market. So if we talk about this packaging, which we have developed, this is already, I mean, Haldiram, Bikane, Bikano, Bikaji, or any local player is using this kind of palettes, this kind of colors, and this product will be there with them. You know, it will not have their separate identity. But with these two kinds of packaging, we have used the elements like arches here, which is like, if you can see the arches here on the center part, which are the indications of Taj Mahal. You know, it is famous for the arches. We've used these things. We've used these minute lines here, which will automatically get your focus on the center part, on the font part, Disha.
So basically, this was a very premium option. So we chose a very royal and rich font. And we, in fact, suggested that for printing also, we'll go for a gold foiling on the products. And like Ankit suggested, these are the inspired from dome on the arches of Taj Mahal. And so is the color palette. It's a very rich and that Mughal feel to it. And again, we also thought of creating a stamp or a seal because there are a lot of duplicate products there in Agra also. So just to give that feeler that this is the authentic Panchi Petha, we created this symbol. Similarly, the option two, now if you see Panchi, they have this name Panchi and there is a Panchi on the symbol also. They never used it. We decided to create a pattern. You want to zoom in?
Yeah, this is it. So if you see the logo here, if you see the logo here, it has the birds element in it because the brand name is Panchi, Panchi itself, right? So we thought of why not creating elements out of it and, you know, creating this kind of packaging. And make it very progressive so that it works like, because today for the youth, nachos is much more important. Chips are much more important, but for namkeen like products, it is for older generation.
It's for older generation.
So we want you to pick up this product from the shelf. And how can we do it? We'll place it like that. We plan the packaging like that. It competes in the visibility part. It competes with nacho, right? We use simple, sober, color shades, use the contemporary font, and if how we are using the product shots here. So everything, you know, gets into the consideration. Again, I've explained this already, that seal of trust, product shot, spices which are coming from in-house, which they're using a traditional way of showcasing the product. So how, these are the notations of how to reach. So the team designers of the team of designers, they plan that how they want to showcase the product. This is the space where they want to showcase the product. This is the space they want to put in the logo. This is how they want to put in about the other attributes in the packaging. So these are the things, you know, which gets on the paper. And I mean, look at this planning, a name of the product, logo and the product shot and the seal. So these are the initial sketches, drawings, which, you know, all of the team who are working on the project plans, and then they all put together their brain and do the brainstorming and finalize things and get it up with the digital designs.
Please, again, if you see, while working on the concept, we have a pointers there right in front of the paper. So the target audience is, we know it's masses. Our competitors, we have written there. Then we are playing with different things. We know that we want to emphasize on made in India part. We want to work on that Mughal lattice work. So these are the thoughts that we keep on getting while working on a project, and we just keep on jotting it down. And then we start working on different layout parts. Every time we get an idea, we make sure that we put it down on a piece of paper, right? And later on, once then we just take, achha, this is looking better, I'll work on this option. Then we start working on the option on the system. And that's how we reach to the designs.
So in terms of talking about it to the client, so do you also prefer to show these rough sketches also and then them the digital, or go with the digital?
Khushbu, what happens is, this is all internal process. So client will not understand the nitty-gritties of drawing and sketching, because commercially you are selling these ideas and concepts, right? So you have to show the client in totality this thing. Client will visualize the product once he look at it. It is a 3D mock-up that you design a flat design and you put it on a 3D mock-up, which will give a visualization to the client that, okay, ये पैक होने के बाद मेरा प्रोडक्ट ऐसा लगेगा. क्लाइंट इज नॉट एट ऑल इंटरेस्टेड इन व्हाट प्रोसेस वी हैव डन, हाउ डिड वी केम अप द आइडिया ऑफ पुटिंग अ स्टैम्प हियर, व्हाई आर वी यूजिंग अ ज़िगज़ैग लाइन हियर, व्हाई वी हैव केप्ट द आर्चेस ऑन दिस कर्व्स हियर. दीज आर ऑल इंटरनल. वी विल टेल द क्लाइंट, देन दे विल अंडरस्टैंड, बट दे डोंट वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोसेस.
It's like if you go to a restaurant to have a food, the chef will serve you a good food, but he would never share the secret recipe or the secret ingredient. So these things are basically our assets, and we cannot share it with the client. He will only get further confused, and he might confuse the team also.
Now moving on with the case study 4, it is like stationery and merchandise, which is very important part for any of the businesses or individuals or anybody who wants to get into personalized stationery. So this is again one of the client, Institute Nutrition is the same. This is the same client who owns Institute Nutrition. We have also developed this logo for him. So these are the things which any branding requires us, a letterhead, a envelope, a business card. Now, if you see, it has two business cards. So if a client want to interact in a way where he wants a generic business card, now I'll tell you what is generic and what is a specialized business card. So client has a feedback saying that, okay, I'm traveling in a plane and in a flight, and if some celebrities with me, I want to have something very personalized, and I want to have something very sophisticated and premium. So I want separate business card with my direct line. And he doesn't want to have he want to have a general card which he wants to keep on the clinic, which everybody, his staff members can use and pass it off. So on general, he is using himself as a face, because he thinks and he feels and he is the face of the brand. So he has kept his face on the business card with his logo and the name, and then this is all laser cutted. Let me show you the business cards here, Disha. Get the closer look.
Is it visible?
So if you see this business card, this is laser cutted from center here. Okay. So if he passes on this one business card to anybody, very less people have seen this kind of business card who has a laser cut, and then sides have the golden impact. So we have to plan like this, being a designer, that we come out of the box with a thought process and execute things.
So this card is basically, of course, a laser cut. We chose a black thick paper for this, and the content has been screen printed, and of course the sides are those are basically golden gilding. So those are golden painted, hand painted.
और एक और चीज बच्चों को मैं बताना चाहूंगा कि कितना ध्यान रखना पड़ता है कि अगर कार्ड में लेजर कटिंग है सेंटर में, तो ये जो पार्ट्स हैं कार्ड में, ये चीजें मोड़े ना, ये कागज फटे ना, doesn't get torn. We have to think that we have to use the thick paper, the quality of paper, what kind of printing we are doing. Everything gets into the consideration.
So this is not a single sheet. We had to took two different sheets and we got them pasted, and then the process happened.
So this is the card you were seeing earlier. This is the closer shot.
So this is a gift card. So again, he had a concept that when I'm traveling, I want to have a gift card that I can give to my clients. And so basically, this is a screen printed card. It is a die cut card, anything which has a shape, outer shape. So this is a rounded rectangular shape. So it's a die cut gift card. This whole part is screen printed. And we had a lamination also over here. So he wanted, I need space so that I can write a message on a gift card and I can just hand over it to my clients.
I'll come up with the ideation that how did we plan? What is the brief? I'll explain it. So client owns certain clinics, around 50 clinics across India. And they have huge traffic for the patients who are taking services for nutritional coachings. So they want to gift the cards and they want to gift coupons to their clients who are very premium and paying high end. So he said, I want a gift card. So we can't just give a gift card like this. Okay, we can't. So we wanted to make something very implicative and very premium. So we came up with a pouch. We planned a pouch like this thing. And this is the cover. We did a gold foiling process here. So we planned it digitally first and then got it printed. I'll show you the printed part also. So on the one side of the pouch, we'll put the gift card and the other side we'll put the business card as per his preference. He wants his personalized business card or he wants the generalized business card. So what happens? So somebody comes in, he passes on this business card to them, this complete gift card. He opens it like this and it has two pouches. So somebody interacting with the business card, it works like this. And somebody interacting with the gift card, it works like this. Now, how this idea came up of this pouch? This idea came up that we go to resorts and on holidays, they give the room key in this kind of pouches, right? So we planned from there that, okay, if they can do that, why not plan a product here and design it for our client to give the gift cards and visiting cards?
In fact, I'll show you the printing process for this also. If you see the front part, this part is basically golden foil. This stamp, this is screen printed. And the inside thing, so we took a orange sheet only. On orange paper, our printer basically did a black screen printing. So this is the orange sheet and then he printed black on it. And here also we've done gold foiling. Something like this is not possible on a digital print.
What is the difference between digital print and screen printing? So I'll explain. Digital is all something which is coming out like a normal printer we are interacting with. We take a normal printout. So that's a digital print. And screen printing is we create a frames and then that particular person who's having that frames and whatever the print thing which we want to, you know, come up with. So they create a frame and then manually they run a frame on it and then they keep it to dry and after that they use it. So that's the screen printing.
Screen printing is more of handcrafted work. Digital is like normal printer that we have.
So sometimes, you know, Disha, you explain.
So then he also needed a greeting card.
Personalized greeting card
so that every time there's an occasion or somebody has performed really well or there's a very important celebrity and he wants to send across a card, he suggested I need a A5 card where I can, you know, write down my message also. So we gave him a lot of space inside where he can put down his message. And the whole concept of this card was that these are basically sun rays which are expanding and they're expanding from front to back and inside also. And it says that you grow in your life and you keep
with on the doing power better. Of nutrition.
With the power of nutrition. Again, the whole card is golden foil. So if you can see the orange sheet with golden foiling on it. And then we also printed his inside. Also, we printed the message in gold. This part, the logo, this is basically screen printed. I'll show you the envelope also. So on the envelope, we had, it's a black plain envelope, and we just had the logo in gold foiling. We suggested that we wanted the thing, this gold foiling on the flap also. But then later on, this was screen printed. Because a gold foiling over here might tear the envelope. So this is screen printed. Yeah. Carry back.
So we can move to the question answers since...
Yeah, we can do that. So this was the carry back, all gold foil. Let's move to question answers.
Question answer sessions. So what are the design specifications must have that makes a successful design? For me, it is ease of understanding and ease of communicating that particular message which requires to be communicated. So if it is a logo or a process, that clarity of thought should be there. Right, Disha?
Exactly. I agree with you. And when we talk about must-haves in terms of designing, I would say we need to focus a lot on the color palette and the concept and idea, layouting. These things are very important.
Everything should aesthetically be, you know, getting in sync with each other.
Yes. How much is
current product analysis important for designing a new product? Yes, it is very important. As I gave the example in the product designing where I was showcasing the snack design, we had to understand how they are processing their products, how they are, you know, measuring at the same store level and putting in, packaging it up, using the stickers, and then what is the vision of the client, that how do he want to, you know, pitch in with the product to the consumer. So we have to understand what is at present and what is required for future. So that's how we differentiate and we'll create a product. What does our ideation process looks like?
That we have already shown.
Ideation is completely that design process of six steps.
Six steps.
On which stage do you involve client for approvals? Once we are up with concept and ideation and we plan something on the first hand, that is the place when we pitch in saying that, okay, this is the first draft. Please tell us, how do you like it? And from there, we judge whether it is a conflict in terms of understanding or whether we are on the same page. And then in second run or third run, we, you know, automatically we all fall in line. Which are the different types of printing methods used on different surfaces as shown before? We usually use two kinds only, digital and screen printing. Any tips for budding designers in terms of career aspect of graphic designing that a graphics design specialist would only tell?
So the only tip that we can give right now is that if somebody is interested in graphic designing, they should study hard. They should have that creative, that inclination, and they should be interested. Because this is not a form of art. It's a very functional thing. So if you enjoy drawing, it could be a career option, but you really need to understand the functionality.
I will like to add one of my bit, because she's my wife. I have already seen her from last 8 years, how she has, you know, designed things. To all the designers, to even kids, please don't follow anything or anybody. Yeah. Follow your mind and follow your aspirations. Even you draw a line, you should have a confidence to explain why you have drawn a line. Right. And that will really make a difference for everybody out there.
So which softwares do you use for designing? We use Adobe Suite. So it's Adobe Illustrator, Photoshop, then InDesign, After Effects. And for ideas, it's of course paper, pencil. That's it. If we have to do any illustrations, so we have our own tablet back home where we illustrate. So yes.
So over to you guys. Yeah, any questions, please ask.
There are two questions. One, could you share any thoughts on space designing? So they, our students also have this project where they have to design some space. So if you can, share some example or any ideas how to go about that in terms of 3D modeling or something.
So when you're asking about space design, I'm assuming you're talking about the wall graphics and murals or like a interior sort of?
A sort of space like community space designing. Where people can meet, talk, something on those.
Okay. I'll give you an example for that. So what happens is like a community is coming up with a community hall, right? And kids have to plan that hall and then aesthetics of the walls and everything. So kids have to understand that what is the dominance of the community? What kind of people lives there? What is the age group? Buzurg jyada rehte hain, ya all age group jyada rehte hain. Which area is that community belongs to? Kids have to understand that they have to, you know, also take care of their regional aspects, understandings, language, color aspects. These are some of the basic things they have to understand and they have to, you know, properly take care of, and then they can, you know, create anything out of it. Disha?
Yeah, exactly. The whole thing is understanding your target audience. So if there's a community hall or any space that you want to design, you need to understand firstly the constraints you have, the target audience you have, and if there's a need of DIY, if there's any budget constraints, so what all things we can do. When it comes to wall graphics, it's again the same six-step process that what you plan to do on the walls or anything.
Next question.
Yeah. So there was another one, that how do you manage the balance between form and function when it comes to designing different, cards or any welcome kit or anything?
Could you more elaborate on this?
So we know these two aspects of designing when it comes to form and function. So if you have to produce some ideas, so how do you take care of those two aspects? So it's sometimes the client might look for only aesthetics and not the, some big background idea towards. So how do you cater to those requirements?
I'll take over this. So what happens, the client wanted something different here. I'm just giving an example of the business card. This is a product for him, right? So then, okay, then our brainstorming team, you know, did some research, what different we can do. Then somebody came up, sir, why not do a laser cutting in the business card of the logo? Then we thought, yeah, laser cutting karega to aisa to nahi, wo jo elements hai, ye iske jo alphabets hai, ya beech mein jo kuch part chhoot raha hai, wo mudega to nahi, paper halka to nahi hai. Then how do we do? We do a background check. We get back to the printer asking him, do we have thick paper? Can we do this? You know, is it literally possible? Can this logo be, you know, carved out of thin paper or a thick paper? How much thick paper do we need to take? This all comes with experience, actually. You know, ideas can be, you know, crafted from anyone here. So our team is full of people who are 25 years also and 30 years also. So generally, idea comes from young people, young students who are there aligned with us in internship. Wo idea dete hain, but with our own experiences, we try and make things execute. We talk, we do background check with our printers, our vendors, whether it is possible or not. And then after that, we create dummies. And once the dummies passes with the whole execution, we finally showcase it to the client. So that's how the process of form and formation wala thing.
Yeah. Any other questions?
I think there was one question from Mayur sir earlier. So if you were to make a welcome kit for any organization, let's say for a school, then what all things would you include in that kit?
Okay. Five must have. Number one, welcome kit for a school should have a prospectus or some detailed thing for what school is offering with different kind of facilities. Then I would say it should have certain merchandise of the school, like some lanyard, some stickers to go on the laptop, or the notebooks, pens, labels, which will go, a badge, you know, which will create some brand fascination in terms of kids who are engaging. Because what happens is a personalized diary from a school, like aapne diary print karake rakhi hai aur aap last mein ek stamp mein bachche ka naam dal ke uspe punch karke usko bhejte hai, that will be a very great impact for a kid, because he's getting that personal attention in that kid. So kit is there, uniform, but if it is highly personalized, it will be a next level interaction even for kids and his parents as well. So that's how school is showcasing that they are taking care of and every kid individually. So these basic things, 5-6 items, will make a huge difference.
And the other things that can be added in the media kit would be like, so you welcome have kit. Welcome kit would be like a personalized greeting card to welcome that kid. Or you can have some flyers which show what all things are there in the school, important things. So it's whether it's your amphitheater or the canteen, the best part of the canteen. So some nitty-gritties. And then, like Ankit suggested, all these merchandise, a t-shirt or maybe a bag, these things help a lot to, you know, attract the child and he'll feel more comfortable.
Okay. Okay, thank you so much. I think we are actually running short of time. So I would like Hia to share the vote of thanks on behalf of our school. Hia,
I would like to thank Sandesh ma'am for removing time from the busy schedules to help us out and enlighten us and make us into better problem solvers and design thinkers. Your words of wisdom has immensely impacted us and helped us in our design cycle as well. Thank you so much, especially in the course of this pandemic. It means a lot to us students and it will really help us a lot in our MYB journey. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting us. And we hope that we've helped you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you for inviting us. And
follow us on our social media handles. You'll get more insights.
Sure, definitely. Thank you so much for taking your time. And the session was really fruitful. Thank you.
Thank you, Tulsa.
Yeah, have a nice day.
Yeah. Same
to you guys.
Bye.
Bye.